It's time again for the Science Bowl.
Zoo parade for five. What big teeth the hippo has are actually a pair of these. Science potpourri for 10. Would a snake most likely eat every day? Every week, Dateline Science for 10. Why are some elephants wearing necklaces these days? Green things for 15.
And now, here's your host, Mr. Z himself, Dave Zarin.
Thank you, and welcome to this special edition of Science Bowl. Today's winner goes on to become the last of the Final Four, joining Martin Luther King, Hyattsville, and Walker Mill in this year's middle school finale. Let's meet today's competing teams. First, from G. James Golson Middle School, would you please welcome Emmanuel Apollyon, Jeffrey Torres, and Dejanay Daly. And from Greenbelt Middle School, say hello to Noah Riggs, Riley Komisar-Burry, and Nuzat Zahin. And now here are the categories of questions we use on the Science Bowl.
Okay, Mr. Z, here's today's categories. Green things, questions about plants and all things green and growing. Zoo parade, a Noah's Ark of questions about animals. Body systems, we'll see how much you know about yourself, about things like breathing and growing and digesting your food. Let's get physical. Questions that test your knowledge of physics and chemistry, earth science and space science. Then there's science potpourri. Here's a grab bag of science questions, everything from air pollution to the kitchen sink. And finally, Dateline Science. We'll ask you about science history and science in the news.
Here on the Science Bowl, our game board reflects question difficulty with the easier questions on the left worth 5 and 10 points. Tougher ones, 15, 20, ultimately 25, toughest of them all. Both our teams start out at 50 points apiece. No penalties ever for incorrect answers. And today's winner will be in the winner's circle along with three other schools, a semifinalist in this year's middle school competition. We have a defending champion here today, Greenbelt. Good game ahead. Let's make sure everything works properly. Jeffrey, try that buzzer. Looking and sounding good, as do you, Dejanay and Emmanuel. Riley, give it a push if you would. Thank you, ma'am. Good luck to you, to Nuzat, and to Noah. And congratulations for making it this far in the competition. You guys are terrific. We're going to have a good game here today. All right. We're getting a thumbs up from Noah over there. I agree. We go G before GR. GJ comes first, so the red team starts out. Jeffrey, pick one for me.
Green things for 15.
Green things for 15 points. Teams, I wouldn't nibble on them, but the berries and the bracts and the leaves of this quintessential Christmas flower are not as poisonous as we once thought. Not as poisonous as we once thought. What Christmas flower, Jeffrey?
Cranberry.
Not cranberry. What'd you think, Greenbelt?
Mistletoe.
Poinsettia. The poinsettia. Try again, red.
Green things for 10.
Green things for 10 points. Teams, strange but true. Detecting explosives is now possible because scientists are putting carbon nanotubes inside these green leafy vegetables that made Popeye very muscular.
Spinach.
Greenbelt.
Spinach.
Yeah, I love my spinach. Good. Go green.
Let's get physical for 15.
For 15 points, and let's get physical. Teams, a water strider is an insect that walks across the surface of the water because water has very high surface what?
Tension.
Yeah, surface tension. Yeah, you got the giggles on over here. All right, make sure you pay attention to me. Go again, green.
Dateline Science for 10.
For 10 points. Teams, recently zoologists found a... Emmanuel, got to listen to me. You got to watch me. Recently, zoologists found a millipede with 414 legs. Not this number, which you might expect, given the name of the creature. Jeffrey?
A million.
Not a million. Good try. A millipede, its name sounds like it should have this many legs. The one they found had 414.
A thousand?
A thousand, yeah. Sometimes they call them thousand-leggers. Thank you, Noah, for your help. Go, Riley, you pick one.
Science potpourri for 20.
20 points. All right, this is an interesting question. You got to listen to me. You got to follow along. I'm going to take you back in history. President Harry Truman, back in 1950, went to Disneyland. He refused to go on the Dumbo ride because he was a member of what political party? Greenbelt.
Democratic.
He was a Democrat, and of course, Dumbo was an elephant, the symbol of the Republican Party. You're with me. Good. Green.
Body systems for 25.
Body systems for 25. Big one in that category is a visual question. Everybody look at the monitor. The Cleveland Indians in the World Series wore, as this Phillies pitcher is wearing, special retro socks. Look at those socks. Those socks have the same name as the tiny middle ear bone that sounds like the place you put your foot when you ride a horse. Green belts.
Stirrup?
Yeah, those are called stirrup socks. Good. Green.
Zoo parade for 25.
Zoo parade for 25 points is another visual question. Look back at the monitor. This very unusual fish is called an opah. O-P-A-H. It is one of the few fish in the sea that is homeothermic, Jeffrey. Homeothermic. That means that this fish can do what that most fish cannot do.
It can go into multiple types of climates underwater?
Not quite. This fish is homeothermic, which means it can do what, Riley?
Blood temperature.
Regulates its blood temperature?
Absolutely right. Thank you, Noah. Homeo and thermic, you knew it had something to do with heat. We are homeotherms, whereas most fish are poikilotherms, meaning their temperature goes up and down based on the temperature of the water. All right, you're off to a fast start. Come on, guys. Red, let's get in this game. Riley, go.
Dateline science for 25.
Big one in that category. Teams on the television, there are always commercials for Ancestry.com. You send in a sample of your cheek cells, and they tell you, I'm part Norwegian, I'm part African, I'm part Czechoslovakian. All of us have genes that come from these N-initialed cavemen. N-initialed cavemen genes. We all got them, Golson. Jeff, what you think?
Neanderthals?
That's what I want to hear. We all got some Neanderthal genes. Now you're back in the game. Go.
Zoo parade for 10
points. Teams, lions live in prides. Wolves live in packs. And monkeys and baboons, like Boy Scouts and Girl Scouts, live in these. Green belt?
Troops.
Troops. That's it. Good. Green.
Let's get physical for 25. Get
physical for 25. Big one in that category, teams. Question is as follows. You've all heard of the Big Bang Theory. It's a great TV show. It's all about how the universe developed. Well, there is something called the Giant Impact Hypothesis that attempts to explain this satellite. The Great Impact Hypothesis attempts to explain our moon. Our moon. All right, the buzzer says we've come to the end of the first round. It's been mostly Greenbelt thus far. They're at 165. Golson is at 75. Lots of Science Bowl still straight ahead in this special edition of Science Bowl. We'll see you in just a moment. Don't go away. And welcome back to Science Bowl. Nice to have you here today. We've got six outstanding players. We're all dancing to the little Science Bowl music here. You know, we're getting into it. Kind of got the case of the giggles going on here, too. We're having a good time. Very important match here today. Before we ask any more science questions, a few personal ones, let's find out about these young people. If you missed them the first time they were on, over at G. James Golson, a school that is relatively new. You're actually joined at the Cora Rice Elementary School up there here in Landover by FedEx Field. Jeffrey, tell me who your principal is.
Jacqueline Marshall Hall.
Wonderful. And the sponsor of your team?
Miss Henry.
Miss Henry. Wonderful educator, and she really prepared you guys well. And I know this is your first year here,
yes. But
your two colleagues, Emmanuel and Dejanay, they were here last year. And
I wasn't here last year.
Oh, you weren't?
I thought
just Dejanay. All right, so she's back for some redemption here, and she got it. You made it into this quarterfinal matchup here. Tell me about any alternates on your team, Jeffrey.
Alyssa, Trayvon, and Prince and Jakari.
Wonderful, okay. And you told me you have lots of extracurricular activities. You've got some sports going on over there. You got the Science Bowl. What are some other things that you can do at Golson?
Robotics.
Tutoring.
Dance,
yeah. Do you have a band over there or an orchestra?
Yeah.
Music, that's great. All right, and Jeffrey, what do you want to do someday?
I either want to do something involving engineering, computer, or do animation.
Animation, wonderful. All right, nice to have you back. You're a good captain. Came up with that good Neanderthal answer, too. Emmanuel, you told me you're interested in soccer. Yes? Professional soccer someday, maybe?
Yeah, I want to get to the Premier Leagues.
Premier Leagues, okay. And do you follow the World Cup?
Yes, actually, I do.
Yeah, I remember they had it in Rio and actually knew one of the players for the U.S. team. So it's always good to have a personal stake in those things. What do you do in your spare time?
I'm going to watch YouTube. Sometimes I play outside with my friends to play soccer.
Yeah.
And basically sleep.
In sleep, yeah. I remember you telling me that sleeping is something you do well, and not everybody can, but it is so important. Get those 8 hours in. Dejanay, tell us about yourself. Why did you want to be on the show? Why you came back a second year, so you must like something.
Ms. Henry made science interesting.
Yeah, good. Yeah, and we hope you find this both entertaining and informative, that you learn something and also that you teach us something. And what do you see yourself doing? Veterinary medicine, right? Yeah, and you've got a black lab?
Mm-hmm.
And what's the dog's name?
Jazzy.
Yeah, and you have a cat?
2 lovebirds and 3 turtles.
Woo!
And my cat is currently pregnant.
Really? So you're going to have an even bigger zoo.
Kitties.
Are you responsible for all those animals?
No.
Oh, that's good.
Just the cat.
All right, so you got plenty of help there. That's great. Go over to Greenbelt. And Riley, nice to have you back. You were on the elementary team with University Park, and now here you are. You told me at one time you wanted to go into cybersecurity, but you've kind of changed that, right? You got some other options. Give me the list. What are some of the things you're considering?
So I wanted to be like cybersecurity a few years ago, and then I realized that was really difficult, but
right?
I still really like computer-y stuff. So I was thinking either working for Google or working for Pixar, because they're really cool, well-known computer companies, and also like the buildings they work at, they get to ride scooters around.
Not to be underestimated, always look out for the perks, yeah. Like if there's a free soda machine or there's something really cool there, I like your thinking. Tell me about Greenbelt. Who's your principal, Riley?
Mr. Covington.
Wonderful, and the sponsor of your team?
Miss Glenn.
The one and only Miss Glenn. Yeah, she has been helping us for many, many years, just like Miss Henry has, and thank Antoinette for all you do. Riley, any alternates on your team?
Yes, we have Flav and Daniel.
Wonderful. They'll be out in a few moments with Miss Glenn here, and Greenbelt also has a lot of opportunities, sports-wise and extracurricularly, and I think you refer to us as one of the nerd extracurriculars, right?
Yes.
Nerds are cool. Don't let anybody tell you differently. All right. Newsette, nice to have you here. You play the violin and the piano both.
Yeah.
Do you come from a musical family?
No, not really.
So you're kind of setting the standard here,
yeah?
And you told me, I asked you once before you'd like to do this professionally, and you said maybe as a secondary thing. What are you thinking about mainly?
I want to be an oncologist, which is a person who studies cancer. And it's really fascinating to me because no one has found a cure for it yet.
So. Absolutely right. It seems like just when we get close, somehow it mutates and changes, and we're just kind of almost back to where we started. I admire your ambition. And Noah, you're having a good old time over there. Not only are you a happy-go-lucky guy, but you know your stuff. You know your science. How do you know so much science?
I just read a lot, and I have a lot of science books at home. I have one about earthquakes and volcanoes. I have one about just general science stuff.
Yeah. Well, it shows. It shows that you've been retaining all that information. You seem to have a nice curiosity about the world, and that's something I hope you never lose. Let's get back to the game. 75 to 165, Greenbelt advantage. Still lots of points to give away, so Riley, start us out.
Green things for 25.
For 25 points, the big one in that category. Teams, big word, simple thing. If you are a dendrochronologist, what do you spend your days doing? A dendrochronologist, what do you spend your days doing? Greenbelt.
Dentist? No, it's plants.
What'd you think? Plants. And see, yeah, talk among yourselves in case I have to come to you so you have a fallback answer.
Doctor.
Pass to Noah.
No, what do they? What does a dendrochronologist do?
Like, take care of plants.
And not quite specific enough. Jeffrey, do you have any idea? You age trees by counting rings. Chronology, you count the rings of trees to find out how old they are. Try again, Green.
Science potpourri for 25.
Potpourri for 25 points. Your question is as follows. Next year, in August, once-in-a-lifetime event, total solar eclipse. You'll be able to see it here in Washington. The umbra and the penumbra are two terms you will have to know because they refer to what that the sun and the moon and the earth cast.
Shadows.
Green belt.
Shadows?
Yes, those are the shadows. The umbra is the darkest part of the shadow. The penumbra, not quite as dark. Green.
Zoo parade for 20.
Zoo parade for 20 points. Teams, Mr. Ray in Finding Dory sings about a phylum called Porifera. Porifera is the phylum for these absorptive creatures of the sea.
Sponge.
Sponges, yeah. SpongeBob SquarePants, my favorite guy. Go, Red. Okay, Jeffrey.
Green things for 20.
Green things for 20 points. Teams, in Asia, where they grow rice, you'll notice that the farmers don't have to worry about weeds. They don't have to worry about mice or other kinds of insects eating the rice because they do this to the paddies where the rice grows. Jeffrey.
Fertilize the plants?
No, they don't fertilize it. What do they do to the paddies where the rice grows to keep weeds out and vermin away?
Floods?
Yeah, they flood that paddy. So yeah, it keeps anything but the most determined pest away. Go Green.
Body systems for 20.
Body systems for 20 points. Teams, if you started counting the bones in your back, the vertebrae, there are a lot of them, but numbers L1, L2, L3, L4, and L5 stand for these L-initialed kinds of vertebrae.
Ligaments?
Green belt.
Ligaments?
Ligaments?
Not ligaments, good try. The L-initialed vertebrae, what does the L stand for? Lumbar, like lumber. Lumbar vertebrae. Try again, please, Green.
Let's get physical for 20.
Get physical for 20 points. Teams, the ancient astronomers Aristotle and Ptolemy believed in the geocentric theory, which meant that they believed wrongly about this. What did they believe wrongly, Greenbelt?
That the Earth was the center of the universe?
Yeah, they did. Yeah, it finally took Galileo and his heliocentric theory to sit everybody right. Good answer. Go Green.
Dateline science for 20.
20 points. Teams, I think you both know this one. Get ready on your buzzers. These brothers who were bicycle mechanics in,
right.
Yes, Greenbelt.
Right.
The Wright brothers, yeah, they were bicycle mechanics and they ushered in the era of flight down there at Kitty Hawk. Go again.
Zoo parade for 15.
For 15 points under zoo parade. The ai, a very strange creature that lives in Madagascar, has claws instead of nails, and it is one of the only nocturnal members of this order that we human beings belong to, too. We human beings
belong... Mammals?
What's that?
Mammals?
Not mammals, no, good try. What order does the ai belong to, and we humans, too? What'd you think, Greenbelt? Correct answer is primates. Primates. Try again, Green.
Body systems for 15.
For 15 points. Teams, your question is as follows. A high school student in Baltimore recently won $75,000 in the Intel Science Talent Search because he came up with a test for cancer, Nuzat, in this organ that is part digestive and part endocrine.
Large
Jeffrey.
Intestines. Large intestines?
Not large intestine. Cancer in what organ that is part digestive and part endocrine, Riley?
Pancreas.
Yeah, the pancreas. Jack Andraka came up with this test for pancreatic cancer, and he has been lauded around the world. Go Green.
Science potpourri for 15.
For 15 points. Teams, getting the flu is never a good thing, but there is a silver lining. If you get flu forever, you do not have to get another vaccine because you have this for life. You have what for life?
Immunity?
Immunity for life for that strain of the flu. Yes, ma'am. Nicely done, Riley.
Dateline science for 15.
for 15 points. You know this man as a famous artist, but in 1493, he discovered the power of friction, and he also made a drawing of the very first helicopter. In addition, yes, Greenbelt.
Da Vinci?
Leonardo da Vinci, absolutely. Also the artist who painted the Mona Lisa. I didn't even need to get that far. Go.
Body systems for 10.
Body systems for 10 points. Teams, if you are suffering from encephalitis, you have inflammation where in your body? Encephalitis. Where is there inflammation in your body? Greenbelt.
Your throat?
Not your throat. Where do you think, Jeffrey? Encephalitis. See if you did your homework, if you studied those prefixes and suffixes. Cephalo, go ahead. What do you want to tell me? What you got?
In your arms?
Cephalo means head. Head. So it's in your head or in your brain. Green.
Let's get physical for 10.
Let's get physical for 10 points. Teams, in your refrigerator, there is an emulsion. An emulsion is when you put two liquids together that don't normally go together. This emulsion is something that people like to put on bread on their sandwiches. Golson?
Butter?
Nope. Greenbelt?
Jelly and peanut butter.
Jelly?
Mayonnaise. Mayonnaise. Okay, try again, Green.
Science potpourri for 10.
Potpourri for 10 points. Teams, back in 2013, the hottest documentary movie was called Blackfish. It was all about this captive mammal. Blackfish, captive mammal.
Black orca?
You got that right, the orca, the killer whale. Go, Jeffrey. Zooparade for 5 points. Teams, because NFL referees wear the shirts they do, we call them these animals. Golson.
Zebras?
Zebras, yeah. Red.
Green things for 5.
Green things for 5 points. Teams, this video app has the same name as the plant that grapes grow on.
Vine.
Vine, yep. Red.
Let's get physical for 5.
Get physical for 5 points. Teams, you probably never thought about it, but scissors are these kinds of simple...
Levers?
Levers is right. Green.
Body systems for 5.
Body systems for 5 points. Teams, if you're in a really sad movie and you're getting all upset, it might tug at your heartstrings. Heartstrings are actually these kinds of body parts, the Achilles being the most famous. Greenbelt?
Tendon.
Tendon is right. Yep. 2 left. Where next?
Science potpourri for 5.
For 5 points, teams, insects, rats, and fish that are infested with parasites that make them do things that they normally wouldn't do, turn those animals into...
Zombies.
Greenbelt.
Zombies. Zombies?
Zombies, the walking dead. Last question, Dateline Science for 5 points. The minor league baseball team in Jacksonville, Florida, known as the Jacksonville Suns, they've changed their name. They now call themselves these oxymoronic crustaceans. They are now... The Jacksonville?
Jumbo shrimp?
Jumbo shrimp, absolutely right. And with that, we end our game. We'll be back with a wrap up in one moment. Don't you go away. Welcome back. What a game this was. And we have our fourth semifinalist because our final tally today is G. James Golson, 115, Greenbelt, 315. What a game you had. Noah, Riley, and Newsette, congratulations. You are going to join Martin Luther King and Hyattsville and Walker Mill. Maybe a second county championship. Flavin and Daniel, congratulations. And Miss Glenn, thank you for all you do. Just a tremendous team you brought to us today. And let's see some smiles over here from Emmanuel and Jeffrey and Dejanay. You played a great game. And look at the shadow team back there. Trayvon and Prince and Jakari and Alyssa and Miss Henry. What a great team. We loved having you guys here. And there was a little laughing around here today because they were trying on the board over there to make a heart with their answers. So we had two games going on at the same time here. Thanks for joining us today. I'm Dave Zarin. We'll see you next time right here on the Science Bowl. Bye-bye.